Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Magic.
Magic.
Yes. This week, we are doing some more Modern. We did Modern last week, but that was a Patreon thing, so this is a deck. And this is a deck, the one I'm playing, is a deck that I've wanted to play for a very long time. I've just been waiting to get all the cards, and we finally got all the cards for it. So it's a Dredge deck. Kind of a Dredge Vine deck, but you'll see. It was pretty sweet.
And I'm playing an Abzan Flicker deck that uses the new card Eerie Interlude.
Which is also really sweet.
Especially with Eternal Witness.
Right. Yeah, just go infinite. Like every turn, just flicker everything, get back the interlude. It's excellent. And so, of course, it's Trebiakist and Gangsta Boopster. Or Boop Dog, as Boop he likes dog. To be called in the streets. In the streets. Also, you want to see something cool? He goes erect when I do that. Anyways, so in the spirit of gang-related activity, I wrote Blood and Crip on this dice. And you get to pick Bloods or Crips?
Bloods.
You think Bloods? Hey, you got Bloods. So, Bloods have it, and you will go first, and we'll see you in game one. Alrighty, game one. Go ahead and show.
Hand.
And I've got those. Alrighty. Kick us off.
It's gonna be Marsh Flats, crack. Going 19. Gonna go all the way to 17 for Temple Garden.
Mm-hmm. Bird of Paradise, one can only assume.
You would be correct.
I don't think you have any other ones other than like removal, maybe.
Birdie.
Boyd.
Sure go.
Draw a card. Not terrible. In fact, that might be my turn one play instead. So we're going to play a Stomping Ground, going to 18, cast an Insolent Neonate.
Pretty good card.
It is pretty spiffy.
Not for the stats, just for the one ability.
Exactly. And I'll pass the turn.
Untap. Druff turn.
I don't know. Can't be blocked. Unless you got two dudes.
Wall of Omens.
See, Draw that card. Can't block it. He's too insolent.
Enter go.
Ooh, no land.
Yeah, I thought maybe the birds and wall would get me land, but it wasn't the case.
So I think on your end step, I'm going to discard a card, which is going to be Golgari Grave Troll. By the way, I'm going to lay out my graveyard here, I think, because the graveyard is extremely important in this deck. So, be probably better than having it in one little clump here.
Yeah.
So, discard that card. Sacrifice Insolent Neonate to draw a card. And the draw card effect, I think I'm going to replace with Golgari Grave Troll.
Seems pretty decent.
So, we'll dredge 6.
Ooh, nice. You got dredge 5 there. Got two dredge fives.
That's about it. But
yeah, nothing else exciting.
The other thing is, I know that graveyard order does matter in some scenarios. This is not one of them. This deck does not care about graveyard order. So what I'm gonna do is sort stuff that doesn't matter and stuff that does matter. And you can complain and yell at me in the comments if you want. But that's what I'm gonna do. So
I don't know if there's any modern cards that reference.
No, I don't think that. I don't think there are. So, we'll untap. We will go to our draw step. Dredge this Stinky Dimp. I almost said draw card. For 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Yeah, you got Blood Ghast.
Yeah.
And Faithless Looting
does do stuff. So
it's not
that's
too
okay.
bad.
So, that was for the turn. Then I think we will also cast a Faithless Looting. So, on our first draw, we're going to dredge Stinky Dimp. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Got another Blood Ghast.
Pretty good. And none of those do anything. So, I didn't get any Dagmar Salvages, right? No. So, I guess our second draw is actually going to be a draw. How boring is that?
It's pretty sad.
And then we will go to discard, and we will discard Golgari Grave Troll and Stinky Dip.
Oh!
So.
You also missed a land drop. You also missed a land drop, but
play
potentially
land
All right, you're discarding for Faithless Looting. I thought it was end of turn.
No. So I think our land drop is going to be a tapped Watery Grave. Getting back two Bloodghasts. Pass the turn.
They can get around the wall.
They can.
Drift turn.
Sweet.
That works out. Kitchen Finks. Go back up to 19.
Pretty good. Pretty good, man.
Enter go.
So we'll untap. Go to our draw step. Dredge Golgari Grave Troll for 6. Ooh, jeez. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Some vegetables.
And Faithless Looting.
It's a Dakmor Salvage. Not bad. Then, let's see here. Well, I think it's not a ton of harm in attacking you for 4.
I think we'll block both.
Okay.
One dies.
Oh, yes. One does stay alive.
Flicker. Go up 21.
Doesn't really flicker. Kind of dies and dies persists. Return.
And then it gets a -1/-1 counter.
Yeah. Okay. Then we will play this Stomping Ground untapped. Going to 16. Getting back Bloodghast.
Never ever truly gone.
And then we will flash back a Faithless Looting. So,
Stinkweed Imp.
Stinkweed Imp is first on the draw. Dredge 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Got Amoeba.
Narcomoeba comes into play. Those are not useful. These are. Okay. So, still have another draw trigger. So I think that one's going to be Life from the Loam. Dredge 3. Hit another Life from the Loam.
That's about it.
And that's about it.
And your library is less than half the size.
Yeah. So now we will discard 2 cards, which are going to be
Stinkweed Imp and Grave Troll.
You read my mind. It's not that hard to read, though, I suppose.
No, not really.
Pass a turn.
Untap. Draw turn. Jurgo.
Okay. Untap. Looks like you're stuck at 3, so I don't have to face down a Resto this turn, I don't think. Unless you're running Simeon Spirit Guide, I suppose. So for a draw step, we will dredge Grave Troll. 6. 3, 4, 5, 6.
That's pretty decent.
Yeah. I mean, they had to be in there somewhere. I hit a lot of poop.
That is true. You got all the poop to start.
Mm-hmm.
Got to get that out of the way.
3 vegetables. That's a lot of vegetables. Okay. Then, what will we do? We don't control any zombies, so we can't go do any shenanigans with grave crawlers, unfortunately. Grave crawler and Vengevine, of course. That's what I mean. So,
2 Neonates would do it for the Vengevines.
Hmm. That's true. That they would. I think what we'll do is try and go big here. Cast a Faithless Looting from a graveyard. Let's go ahead and sort out what we've got here, just for reference. A couple Grave Crawlers and some Dredge stuff. Another Faithless Looting. So, we will. So we're casting this. First things first, we'll get back a Stinky. Dredge 5.
There's the big hitter.
Yeah, that's a good man. Now, I think these actually trigger all at the same. Like, if I stack it correctly, these all trigger in a nice way. Because I would. They'd all enter at the same time. And then. Oh, no. I guess it doesn't matter. Narcomoeba's trigger goes in the stack.
Yeah.
Enters the battlefield. So Narcomoeba actually reads when it's put into your graveyard from your library, you may put it into play. So that counts as going into play. which triggers these prized amalgams. Whenever a creature enters the battlefield, if it entered from your graveyard or you cast it from your graveyard, then you return the amalgam to the battlefield on your next end step. So those are primed to trigger. And we have another draw. So
I think you have another stinkweed in there.
I don't want to deck myself. It's the only thing I'm really worried about.
Yeah, you don't really want to deck yourself on turn four.
No. Well, I think it's past turn four, no?
Oh, yeah, I guess.
I haven't missed a land drop.
Yeah, you haven't missed a land drop.
That's true. We can afford to do it one more time, I think. Pretty sure.
Stinky. So
we'll get another stinky for five. One, two, three, four, five.
This is the fourth Narc Amoeba.
Fourth Narc Amoeba. And these are good. So, now we discard two things. I'm thinking probably, this doesn't really make a difference, Grave Troll Imp. Then,
they've done their work.
They have done their work. Let's see, what have you got here? So these two entered, correct? Or did three enter this turn?
Two entered.
Two entered, okay. Get in there.
So before blocks, I go for Eerie Interlude.
It's pretty good.
Exile any number of target creatures and return them to the battlefield at the end step. Wait, I was going to block first. That's what I meant to do. Let's block those.
Okay.
And then flicker.
Sure, whatever.
Take two. Go 19.
Three, right? Or were you blocking two ghasts?
Two ghasts.
Oh, okay.
Flying.
Sure. So, oh, if you're flickering in response, then I guess these don't...
Yeah, they don't die.
Okay, so those are primed to come back as well.
On the end step.
On the end step. So I think what I'll do, play a tap Dakmor Salvage, getting back this blood ghast.
Blood.
Oh, two in here. And then
ghasts.
Then what? Then we will pass the turn. So I'm not sure whose triggers happen when, but I don't think it matters.
I think the active players go on the stack first.
Yeah? Okay. So
mine would resolve first, but it doesn't really matter.
No, doesn't make a difference. So
I go back up 21, and I get a draw card. I'm not sure that's going to save me.
And I will obviously pass turn, because I think I did already.
Draw turn. Ugh. This one lander just did not work out.
Yeah, you got some stuff, just not fast enough. I'm thinking.
Green. Oh.
By the way, to anyone watching, I apologize if this mess is confusing to you, but might be helpful. I don't know.
Yeah, the graveyard's pretty relevant there.
Yeah.
And you got Vengevines, Blood Ghasts, Grave Crawlers.
Just keep in mind that everything in play is above this line.
That really doesn't do much. But I guess. It's your go.
Okay. So.
I don't know the cards left in your library. It's five.
Five. So an attempt to not deck myself, which is what I'm going to do. Let's just draw a card.
I mean, there's that Dakmor Salvage there. It's only two.
It's true, but I don't want to... Just in case you somehow can survive this many turns, I'd rather just draw these cards, I think.
Yeah.
So... Unfortunately for me, I don't think that's probably going to be the case. So what we're going to do is we're going to cast one of these grave crawlers from our graveyard because we control Prized Amalgam, which is a zombie.
Yep.
And then we will cast another grave crawler from our graveyard, which triggers these three Vengevines to come back because I've cast two creature spells. So they all come back and play.
That's a lot of beef.
It is a lot of beef. So these can't attack this turn. But everything else can, because Vengevine has haste. You're at 21?
Yes.
So, let's assume block two things. The biggest things. That'd be 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. And if you have the interlude, you can gain life and survive. But I don't think that matters. So I'm going to send in the team. Like so.
So, to start turn, black, white, flash in a white mane lion.
That's pretty good.
Turning the bird of paradise.
Sure.
Then I believe I will path one of the Vengevines.
Ah. Not the lion I was expecting. I'll search for a basic. Oh, look at that. No basics.
There wasn't a basic left in the four? If there was, would you even get it?
No. Absolutely not. I'd fail to find regardless with that many cards left. So those are my three biggest dudes. And you would be taking 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 15. If you block everything.
Well, we'll block one of the Vengevines.
Sure.
That will go on Prized Amalgate.
Amalgam.
And I think that on the other Vengevine.
Sure. Okay. So that trades for a vegetable, sort of. And the rest of my stuff stays trigger. Alive. Yes.
But I take 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 15.
15.
6, and then Kitchen Fangs triggers. 8.
Okay, so got these two grave crawlers still here. To worry about dying, so I'm going to cast a Life from the Loam to get. It really doesn't make a difference. Let's get some basics. Why not? Let's get those to my hand. And here's a Copperline Gorge. Pass the turn.
Untap. Draw turn.
If you can dig your way out of this, I will be seriously impressed.
Well, I mean, I can path that Vengevine.
Yeah, you can. Once again, I'm not even going to search this time because I don't want to shuffle. No point.
And I can play an Aether Vial and sure go.
Okay. Untap.
No luck.
What do I have left here? 4? And you're tapped out. So I could dredge a Life from the Loam. Dredge 3.
To do it.
Might as well.
Pretty sure you got me.
Pretty sure I got you. Yeah, I don't think there's anything you could have. So that's what I'm going to do. Dredge Life from the Loam. Flipping up Amalgam and 2 lands.
Exciting.
Very much so. Crawler. It's kind of going through the motions at this point.
You should use that Faithless Looting.
No, flashback. I'm not going to do that. Stinky, get back vegetable. And beats with we these men.
Block vegetable.
Yeah.
I guess we can block amalgam and we can block vegetable.
Sure.
And 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 16.
I think it's enough.
19 damage.
I think it's enough damage.
8 minus 19. Yeah, that's good. Yes.
All right. So that was game one.
I had a bit more lands. I think good. I could have.
Oh yeah, you had a lot of stuff. That Aether Vial actually would have been great if you had it on.
Yeah, if it was earlier, game, it would have been excellent. But
yeah. So hopefully in game two you will not fall victim to a mana screw. And we will see you then. All right, game two. Go ahead and show your hands.
Hand.
And I've got that. Kind of a mulligan, but we'll see anyway. Could come in handy. Who knows?
I'm going to go ahead and assume that's a Archimedes.
Absolutely not. Yeah, it is.
Temple Garden, going to 18. Aether Vial.
Oof, it's pretty good. On the first turn. Draw a card. Man. Not bad. Huh. Think what I'm going to do, though, is play this Copperline Gorge, cast a Faithless Looting. So we're going to draw two cards.
No dredge to start it.
No dredge to start it off. And we'll discard two cards, which are going to be Grave Troll and Stinkweed Imp.
Yeah, that's pretty good.
Pass the turn.
Untap. Upkeep. Draw. Marsh Flats.
Mm-hmm.
Enter go.
All right. Untap. Upkeep. We're going to draw this Grave Troll in exchange for six things. Just some more dredgers. Some lands. Not the worst. Not the best. And let's actually just cast another Faithless Looting.
Ooh.
Pretty good. So we'll dredge the Stinkweed Imp for 5. There's some stuff.
Got Amoeba.
Amoeba. Another looting. And we will dredge this imp also for 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
You got Grave Troll.
Grave Troll. This lets me keep going, I guess. I mean, I had other stinkies in there, so. So, then we'll discard two cards. And I think they'll be Stinkweed Grave Troll. And Tapped Watery Grave. Pass the turn.
End of your turn. Crack Marsh Flats. Find. Overgrown Tomb, if it's actually not hiding. There's one. Tapped.
Okay. You are currently facing down a Narcomoeba. I don't know if
threatening.
You're going to be able to get out of this.
Untap. Upkeep.
No ones with the vial.
Draw. Then we're going to go for a Verdant Catacombs.
Mm-hmm.
Crack that, going to 16. Find just a basic forest.
I guess that's also a treasure. Not a particularly great one.
Sometimes it's all you got, though.
Yeah, sometimes you need a land drop. If you haven't got Blood Gas.
I mean, not really in that situation.
No,
but.
No.
And we'll go for Kitchen Finks.
Kitchen Finks. Finks of the Kitchen.
Enter go.
All right. Untap. So we'll dredge Troll for 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Pretty good. Got a Vegetable, Grave Crawler, and a Life and Loam. And some poop. Okay. So, I think the play is probably cast a Grave Crawler, cast a Neonate, get back these Vengevines.
Ugh.
And we will. Can't attack with that one. Send for 9.
Block 1, take 5.
You got it.
Go to 13. Kitchen Fink dies, comes back, go to 15.
Okay. Do I want to do anything funky with the Neonate? Probably not yet. So I'll pass turn.
End of your turn. Violin, White Mane Lion, returning Kitchen Finks to the hand.
It's a pretty sweet line. You got there.
Untap.
Cool lion, bro. Cool lion.
Upkeep. Draw. Here, I think we shall cast Kitchen Finks.
Mm-hmm.
Going to 17. Enter, go.
End of your turn. I will sacrifice Neonate and discard a Grave Troll.
Pretty decent.
To draw a card, which I will replace with a Grave Troll. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Got a Bloodghast. That's new.
He's not a dredger, though.
And some other stuff. No, but he's a threat, at least.
I thought you were separating dredgers.
Oh, I was at one point.
That's why I mentioned it.
Yeah. I should be consistent, probably.
Otherwise, you'll forget it's there at some point.
Yes, exactly. Okay, so untap. And go to draw step. Here's a troll. Let's go for 6, 4, 5, and 6.
Ah, there you go.
Another Bloodghast.
Amalgam. Amalgam.
And a handful of Grave Trolls. Pretty good. Pretty good stuff. Let me see. White Mane Lion and a Kitchen Sphinx. Lion doesn't have reach or anything stupid like that, I assume.
One just one flash. Flash bounce something.
Mm-hmm.
Mandatory bounce something.
Sure. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and I think we're gonna cast this Gravecrawler from our graveyard, triggering this Amalgam. And then we will attack with all of these men.
Well, start.
4-7.
Here's another Finks.
Sure. Pretty good. Pretty good, man.
And I guess we should go up to 19 first.
Yeah.
Block Vengevine. Block Gravecrawler.
Okay. So take one.
Take one. 18.
These both
die. Come back. Go 22.
Okay. Do any other faithless lootings or anything like that? So, end my turn. Prize the Amalgam comes back into play.
Not even a land drop for the Bloodghasts. Convenient. Nope.
Although I could get one next turn.
Untap. Should
be Drough pretty turn. Good. We got in here. Yeah.
Vert Catacombs crack. Going to 21. We'll find a forest.
Mm-hmm.
Snow-covered forest.
Much better. Everything's better when it's covered in snow.
Swinging for 6.
That snow is Mr. Boopster. Swing for 6. Well, I cannot block that, so I will take it. Going to 14.
Violin and Eternal Witness to get back a Verdant Catacombs.
Sure.
And cast Eerie Interlude.
Oh, God. That's pretty spooky. Okay, why don't you explain how this works?
So it exiles any number of target creatures you control and return those cards to the battlefield at the beginning of the next end step.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to choose these ones. White Mane Lion can stay because sure. He kind of bounces something.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, you know what? He can come with.
Okay. So, yeah.
This goes to the graveyard. End my turn. They all come back. Eternal Witness trigger. We'll get back Eerie Interlude. I gain 4, going up 25. And I'll return Eternal Witness to my hand.
Alright.
Enter, go.
Okay. Got to deal with this fast, I think.
Because I can do that every turn.
Do that every turn. So we'll untap. What's my best bet here? I think my best bet is honestly to... I just dredge the salvage so I get a land drop. That's pretty sad. And you're at what, 25?
25.
That's what I'll do. I will dredge Life from the Loam in my draw step. Dredge 3. Jeez.
That's a good dredge.
All right. So.
That is an excellent dredge 3.
Yeah. So we'll draw that there, Life from the Loam. Then we will... I guess I might as well really attack with everything. So I will attack with these two. 4-5. Or 4, sorry.
I believe I'll block 3 of it.
Sure.
Take 1. He dies, comes back. 26. He didn't accomplish too much there.
No. So then... I will cast Life from the Loam, getting back that, which curiously enough comes in untapped, which is kind of hilarious. Actually, one of these should be a Blood Crypt, I think. We can, we'll take the Foil Mountain over the non-Foil Mountain.
It is superior.
So we'll take those 3 from Life from the Loam. Then, see him at 14. We will play a Blood Crypt untapped, going to 12, which will get back 3 Blood Ghasts and trigger these 3 Amalgams. And actually, want to cast this Gravecrawler? Not really. So I will pass turn, getting these 3 Amalgams.
Untap. Upkeep, I believe we'll leave Aether Vial where it is. Draw turn.
Because you only have like Angel at 4.
Verdant Catacombs, crack.
Mm-hmm.
Going, 25. It's actually going to go all the way down 23. And find us. Another Temple Garden.
Mm-hmm. Got here. Whole bunch of stuff.
Swing for 7.
Not gonna block it, because I can't. So no weird tricks.
No weird tricks.
Pick 7. Go to 5.
And then we'll violin Eternal Witness.
Mm-hmm.
And cast.
You're not going to get anything back with the Witness?
All right. I guess I can get a
Might as well get a land. It's not a huge reason not to.
And cast Eerie Interlude.
Mm-hmm.
Not going to get the White Mane this time.
Yeah. It's kind of just a pain to do.
If I had more
it
mana.
It does come in untapped.
Like next time.
Can you choose to do nothing with it?
No, it's a force. It could return itself, I guess.
Yeah.
But that's not. I could cast it, but it's not really worth it.
True. I mean, it's useful to have it tapped, to be fair.
Yeah, because it can be reused later.
Or untapped, rather.
And we'll end our turn. Gaining 4 and getting back the Eerie Interlude from the graveyard.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Let's see.
And your go.
So you're at 27?
27.
So that's how much damage I have to deal. Pretty much now. Because you don't have 3 mana up, and you're just going to repeat the cycle every turn. Can I do that? I don't know. Let's see. Untap. For my dredge, it's going to be Troll. So dredge 6. blood gas and an archamoeba. Pretty good.
Can't go wrong with an archamoeba.
So we'll get that. These go there. This goes here. You are not at 10 life, so that's not a, a thing that can happen.
No haste.
Let's see here. So that's summoning sick. The rest of these aren't. So let's assume you block those. 3, 6, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Which is not enough, but it's not bad. So play Mountain. It's our land for the turn. Get that blood guest. Then we will cast this Gravecrawler and cast this Stinky, getting back two Vengevines.
Vengevines.
And then let's just send with all the men, probably. Send with all the men that I can. Which are these men?
So I block the two Vengevines.
Mm-hmm.
How much am I taking?
If you block the two Vengevines, you take 3, 6, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Which will put you at 9, and then you gain 4. Going to 13.
And I think I'm going to block a Vengevine and Amalgam.
Sure.
And we're going to path the other Vengevine.
All right. Should I even bother to look?
I guess you gotta count.
So there's three in play. I think I've got one more mountain, but I should be weary of this. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yeah, screw it. Not even gonna look. So you're blocking, what'd you say, Amalgam and a Vengevine?
A Vengevine.
Okay. So that's 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 damage. Which puts you at 12.
12.
So then these two things die.
These two things die. Come back with minus one counters. Go up to 16.
Mm-hmm. And I guess that is a turn. So I'll pass it.
Untap. Upkeep, we're going to tick this up.
Mm-hmm.
Draw turn.
So we have two blockers, essentially.
An Archimeba and a Stinkweed Imp.
Yes. Which will theoretically keep us alive.
It's one toughness. Those have one toughness at the moment.
Two. Yep.
Swing.
Swing with everything. Well, so is everything now a 2-1? Is that saying there's a counter on each?
Yeah, there's a counter on each.
I mean, I should just know that, but, you know. So
we only have one sign dice, so.
Sure, sure.
Getting to use a minus sign is fun.
Let's go like that. Yes.
We are going to violin a restoration angel, which will save that from combat.
Mm-hmm.
Comes back in, I'll get path. And should we use path on Archimipa to save our one thing? Yes.
Okay. Not going to look. I will take two.
Four.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, four. Four. Go to one.
And then second main. Eerie interlude.
Sure.
Flickering these guys.
Not gonna angel?
All right, and angel.
Yeah. Okay. So, end step.
End step, they come back. Turn eerie interlude.
With the witness.
Game. Go up to 20. Resto a
four. Yep.
Pigeon finks. Go to 22.
22. Okay.
Your go.
22. Untap. I'm not sure if I can get there. You have four blockers. Don't know if I can deal 22 damage with these men. We'll see, though. I'm just going to sort these a little bit. Okay, draw step. Draw step. How many cards we have left? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 cards left. I think... Let's see, am I dead on a backswing? Guess I've got some chump blockers. So not entirely. What to do here? This is surprisingly tough. So there's two grave crawlers, which means I've got one more in there. Because it's not in my hand. And there's another amalgam in there as well.
You have seven. You can go for broke.
I actually can't because I don't have a...
Oh, there's no grave troll
in here. Most I can do is five. Is that correct? To dredge for five. Man, why do you make it so difficult on me? And I'm dead in two turns, but I kind of am anyway.
Yeah, you can't really block the air forever.
No. So... You've killed one Vengevine. There's one there, which means there's still a Vengevine in there as well. I think the play is two. You've got a green up. I'm kind of liking. Gonna have to actually block everything. So one, two.
Needing the five blockers in that case.
Yeah. I've already used Vial. So I have to leave those ones back, which sucks. This is just not a... I don't think this is a winnable position at one, unfortunately. Let's see. So we get that one. Not a winnable position. Not a winnable position. I guess we I'm just gonna gain life too. I guess we attack like that. It's not very good, but that's what we'll do.
So we'll block three blood ghasts.
Sure.
Take six.
You're blocking three blood ghasts with what? Those three?
Okay. Yeah.
Sure. Sure.
Go to 16.
So, what got through then.
Six damage.
Yes. Yeah. Okay.
Healing four, so down to 20.
Well, here's a land. Here's some blood ghasts. That triggers amalgam. Then, I think best move is to cast another stinky, which does not trigger Vendivine, because I did not cast any other creatures this turn. So I will pass turn, get back amalgam.
Did you ever actually draw for your turn?
Did I?
For seven before.
Oh, no, I didn't.
No, you never decided anything. Whether to dredge or draw.
Just kind of bypass that. I'll just draw. Two.
Untap.
It's funny. Yeah, I determined there's not really anything in there that would help much. So,
Drift turn. I mean, it is a white source, really, but it's not a very helpful white source. Vert Catacombs crack. We'll just find our godless shrine tapped.
Okay. Put that in tapped, so no double interlude. Although I guess you can't really in one turn anyway.
No, it is does go to the end step.
Mm-hmm.
But what we can do is violin a Stonehorn Dignitary.
Ooh.
So you skip have your next combat phase.
Mmm. That's pretty good. Okay.
And... oh, he's really attacking. We'll just Eerie Interlude.
Sure. So you gain like 6 total, right? From this interaction.
Well, we're going to go Kitchen Finks. Get back Eerie Interlude with Eternal Witness.
Flicker Finks, I assume.
So Flicker Finks. Let's go 23.
So you gain 6 total. In other words.
Deciding whether I want that path or not, but I don't think I want it this turn. So
okay.
Plus 6, 25.
Okay. Are you good?
Yeah, it's your go.
Oh boy. Alright, untap. Basically, I have everything in play. Draw step. What we got left? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You know, I'm gonna dredge a salvage for 2. I think that's safe. Gravecrawler and a mountain. Okay, then we're going to cast the Gravecrawler. Cast a Narc Amoeba, which triggers this Vengevine to come back. And we'll pass turn, because we don't have a combat phase.
Who needs one?
I needs one.
Untap. Draw turn.
So I've got one amalgam left still. Pretty interesting.
Swing for 6.
Swing for 6.
It's either die slowly with the dignitary or take it, really.
Yeah, I guess you can just keep flickering my combat step, right?
Yup.
Well, 1, 2, 3, 4. You know what we're going to do? Double block.
You need a 5th card for that to work.
Sorry?
Because you have to do exactly. For dredge.
Do I have to do it exactly?
Yeah.
2, 3, 4.
Because otherwise you could just always replace the draw with threat.
Oh, no, I've got it. No. I got it. Block those two.
Okay. Gain 4, going 29. Cast Eerie Interlude.
Mm-hmm.
That's a 6 life and Eerie Interlude back from the graveyard.
Yep.
And...
totally got this. And of course, Dig and Tarry, preventing my combat step once again.
And White Mane Lion staying behind, because otherwise he just annoys it.
Yeah. You good?
Yeah, it's your go.
Untap. Dredge Imp for 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. That was a good
one. The dredge has to be exact. It has to be 5 cards.
Okay, fine. We will get...
that is the one problem.
Does it actually have to be exact?
Yeah, because otherwise you could just always replace draw with dredge and never lose.
Get Loam. Dredge 3. Got one there. Ooh, there's that other Amalgam and that other Vengevine. Nice. And we will cast a Faithless Looting. Drawing 2. And dying.
Yeah,
that's... Trying my best to draw.
That Eternal Witness lock.
It's pretty good. Dignitary really helped me out there. I might have been able to actually squeeze in lethal.
There's one in the deck, and he came at the right time.
That did come in very handy. All right, that was the longest game 2 in history, and we'll see you in game 3. All right, game 3. Go ahead and show my hand. Try and play at a slightly quicker pace this game, because we're already almost in an hour. Your turn.
And
I'm sure you people have much better things to do. So we're going to lead with a Wood of Foothills. Crack
and hang out with Mr. Boopster?
Yeah, that's true. They don't. There isn't a better thing in the world. So we'll crack that. Go get a... not Stomping Ground. Blood Crypt. Untapped. All the way to 17. Oh my god.
One landed on top of your hand.
Okay, and then we're going to cast Insolent Neonate. Pass the turn.
Tough turn. Verdant Catacombs, crack, going to 19.
Mm-hmm.
Finding a Temple Garden somewhere.
Mm-hmm. Untap Bird.
Untap Bird and Jergo.
Okay.
17.
Mm-hmm. Birdie. Squawk.
Birdie.
So, end of your turn. I will discard a card and sacrifice Neonate.
Grave Troll.
And then we'll dredge Grave Troll with our draw. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Got the other Grave Troll.
And you got another Grave Troll.
Really good.
Decent.
That was really good. So, untap. Draw step. Grave Troll. 6. 1, 2, 3, 4,
my
five,
god.
6.
These last two kind of suck, but the rest are good.
Okay. Then. Then what? Then I think. Let's see, that gets 3 things back. Not great. Unfortunately, can't cast this Faithless Looting, which kind of sucks. Start by attacking for 1.
I think I'll take that. 16.
Play a forest, and we will cast Life from the Loam. Getting back.
Full amount.
Let's get these 3. To our hand. And I don't have to discard, so I'll pass turn.
Untap.
I'd actually rather discard, to be perfectly honest.
Verdant Catacombs.
Seems pretty sweet here.
Wall of Omens, who's not doing too much. Enter go.
Untap. Dredge Stinkweed Imp for 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Not terrible.
You kind of need a zombie to get those grave trolls rolling.
Well, I just have to get this Amalgam back into play.
That's true.
Not the you hardest. You have a venge thing vine in
there, but.
True. Let's see. Let me see. I think what we'll do is play this Bloodstained Mire. Crack it, go into 16, and we'll go all the way to 14. Fetch a Watery Grave. It's the only one in here. There it is.
Is that going to be used to cast an Arkamoeba?
No.
No, is that what it's in there really for? That and Amalgam, I guess?
More or less, yeah. More or less. But no, that is going to be used to cast an Amalgam. Tech for one.
Can't block it. 15.
Pass turn. Could if you had your bird up.
Not really worth it, though.
No, absolutely not.
What do we do here? Think Crack Verdant Catacombs. Going to 14.
Mm-hmm.
And find Godless Shrine untapped. Going to 12.
Are you going
to
path my Amalgam? I think you're going to path my Amalgam.
I'm going to path your Amalgam. Just so you don't go Grave Troll or Grave Crawler into another Amalgam.
Well, we'll get a mountain. Because at this stage, I still have some basic lands.
You don't have any blood ghasts in the graveyard, too.
True. Just Grave Crawlers. I would have fetched a swamp, probably, but I don't have one.
Untap. Tough turn. Be a little helpful earlier, not so much now. Is that worth it? I think it is. Temple Garden untapped.
Okay.
And we got ourselves a rhino.
All right. I will lose 3 life.
13.
Going to 11.
Enter, go.
Untap. Our biggest thing to dredge with is Life from the Loam, so that's what we'll do. 4-3. Another life. Prized Amalgam and Neonate. Okay. So we don't have a zombie. It sucks. It's not ideal.
And you didn't hit a blood ghast, which is
no,
really
never
good
hit a blood
me.
Ghast either. And Siege Rhino's a pretty big deal.
He's got the beef.
I think the play is probably. Is it Faithless Looting? It's pretty sad if it's Faithless Looting. But I think it's honestly Faithless Looting. So we'll cast this Faithless Looting from our graveyard. Draw 2. So I can dredge Life from the Loam. 3.
Oh, there's a blood ghast.
And 2 Tormenting Voices, which would have been very nice. And
good in hand, not in the graveyard.
Salvage. Dredge 2. Gravecrawler. Stinkweed Imp. Well, at least that's something. 3
yeah,
Gravecrawlers,
decent.
Though. That's a lot of Gravecrawlers. And we'll discard 2 cards, which will be much better.
Much better dredgers.
I just realized Vengevine for some reason is in there.
It's in the wrong half.
The wrong half. And I think I already... Did I already play a land? No, I didn't. I haven't played a land yet. So, I will do that in the form of, I think, Dakmor Salvage, which gets back this Bloodghast and triggers these 2 Amalgams. And I'll attack you for 1. Why not?
12.
And end my turn, having those come back.
Untap. Druff turn. So I'm very helpful. 4.
Take 4. Going to 7.
Enter, go.
Okay. Untap. Dredge Grave Troll. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Get Amoeba.
Amoeba's good. The rest of these, not really.
Some faith is leaving, go in the other pile, not the dredge pile.
It's just stuff, I guess. Honestly, it doesn't really make a difference. Okay. Forgot to untap that. So this came in this turn. Can attack.
No beats.
You probably have a Restoration Angel. So I'm functionally at 4. I'm just going to assume you do. So, let's see. What to do if you have an angel? Is looting good? Is looting a good cast? I think it probably is. You're at 12, so functionally 15. Sorry, I know I said I was going to play quicker, but it's kind of funny. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
There's too many things involved
7,
to play quickly.
8, 9. Can make a 9-9. That seems pretty okay, making a 9-9. Okay.
9-9 Grave Troll would be pretty scary.
That is what I'm going to do. So, this turn, I'll just send in this bull. Nah, there's really no point in sending in the Bloodghast.
Yeah, there's kind of a wall.
True. Play a mountain. We will cast a Golgari Grave Troll. Oh, I didn't even count these two. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. No, I did. 7, 8, 9. Yeah, I did count them.
9-9.
Make a 9-9. For 5 mana. Pretty good. This is the other mode of Golgari Grave Troll, of course.
The one that's very rarely used.
Yeah. The do something one.
To actually cast the card.
Yeah. And then we will also cast a Gravecrawler, because we control some zombies, which gets back a Vengevine. Pass a turn.
Yeah, I think it's still right to Restoration Angel. Siege Rhino.
You got it.
Drain you for 3. Go to 15.
You've got it.
Untap.
Fortunately, Siege Rhino's probably not getting in unless you got another path up your sleeve, which you might.
Wall of Omens.
That's a blocker.
Verdant Catacombs cracked.
Mm-hmm. Golgari Grave Troll is a skeleton troll.
Wait, he's a skeleton?
He's a skeleton troll.
I always thought he was just a troll. So is that like the flavor? Is that he's actually just a skeleton, and in order to have meat, he has to wear other dead creatures?
Yeah, I guess so. I guess so. That's probably what it is. Do-do-do.
And
it's a big boy.
That, I think, will play another wall of them.
Oh my god. So many walls.
We'll just clog the board.
Apparently. Jeez.
Enter, go.
Okay.
I mean, who needs to attack on the ground?
For another one of these long games, apparently. Untap. Dredge Troll for 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Pretty good.
Yeah, that
all of those
one.
Do something. 2 vegetables, 3 Bloodghasts, and another Grave Troll. Just can go over there. Okay. So, what's our plan? I think our plan, you are tapped out.
I have a birds.
You have a birds. Send in this big old troll. which I kind of like.
He's just a 9/9. He doesn't have trample, right?
He doesn't have trample, no. I can regenerate him by removing a counter, though.
And paying cool. One.
I will attack you four. You just have so many walls. It's really annoying.
Three Wall of Omens.
Three Wall of Omens. Like that. Yeah.
Troll and Avenge Vine?
Troll and Avenge Vine.
Well, I'll block Troll with Siege Rhino.
Okay.
Because that's pretty free. And I'll block Troll with...
So you're blocking Troll with Siege Rhino?
Sorry, I'm blocking Venge Vine with...
I mean, I'm fine with it if you want to do that, but...
Like that.
Okay. So take out one Wall of Omens. Exchange for this vegetable.
He's got to break down all the walls.
Exactly. Okay. Grave Troll. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13,
13.
This one is.
Oh! That's a big boys.
13, 13, Grave Troll. And we will cast the Grave Crawler because we control these amalgams, which triggers these three Venge Vines. And then we'll play a Copperline Gorge tapped, which triggers these three Bloodghasts.
And I'll pass it. Okay, so this better be a Stoneforge signatory, is all I can say.
Can you seriously draw it? Oh my god.
Wall of Omens.
Oh, okay. That's better.
That's better for you, yes. Yeah, I don't think that's enough.
Another Wall of Omens? No?
No, there's only five in the deck. Mm. Or four in the deck, sorry. There's not a fifth.
Yeah.
Kitchen Finks.
Okay. If that was the flicker card, you actually had me dead. Because you get two Siege Rhino activations. But as it stands, I think I've got enough blockers to survive this game.
Here we go.
Question is, do you? I don't know. Let's find out. So it's 16. Oh, God. It's horrible. It's so horrible. Dredge Grave Troll. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Got another Narcomoeba.
Get another Narcomoeba in play. Summoning Sickness. And that was basically it. Got some Imps. Some other stuff. You are tapped out, so that's easy on the math. Or easier, I suppose. Okay. So you've got...
Six blockers.
Six blockers. And you're at 16. So...
Obviously,
those ones.
The 9 and 13.
Obviously, these ones, because they're the next biggest ones. And then an Amalgam, which pushes through 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 15, 16, 17. Yes? Am I right about that?
Yes. Yeah, you got me.
12.
I had a rest, 14, though, but 15, 16, wasn't going to do enough.
Okay, is there any fun stuff I can do? You know, this has gone long enough. Yoink!
Yeah.
All right. So, some blocked those things that. Get blocked. 17 pushes through. Narrowly squeaked that. Well, sorry to narrowly squeak that one by. Oh, that would have been.
Well, I had one in hand, too.
Oh, you had one in hand. Oh.
But man. It only puts you to one, so I decided to gamble on that wall of them.
Sure. That would have been pretty good. Anyway, so. That was
Victory!
Dredge, the most messy playing field I think I've ever had. And that was Dredge versus, what is this deck actually called?
Abzan Flicker.
Abzan Flicker. Pretty exciting stuff. So we'll be back tomorrow with a pack crack, where I will be cracking a pack with Mr. Boopster here.
Boopster!
And we'll see you the week after with some more Magic.